but back to the first match. And that is how the singles draw has played out. We have Mima Ito and Yu Mengyu on one side of the draw. Mengyu lost to the world number one Cheng Meng in straight sets and straight games rather, and Mima Ito also losing her semi-final in straight games. Were you surprised at how she lost that? Because she was playing so well, wasn't she, Mima Ito?
Yeah, Mima Ito is simply incredible, a tour de force, and she's got a very unusual style. You can see her racket out there on the table close to us. She's got short pips on the backhand side. Now, for those of you newer to table tennis, first of all, welcome to the wonderful world of table tennis. This is Tokyo 2020, as you can see branded on the beautiful table, which is actually shaped like a T, not only for Tokyo, but for table tennis, TT, or TTT for that matter. So Mima Ito's game is unlike any other. Now, I say that, at least in the modern game, her predecessor, Ai Fukuhara, daringly known as Ai-chan in Japan, changed the sport forever. She has a statue here in Tokyo. She fought for a bronze medal in 2016, which is why Mima Ito, despite being at the Olympics in Rio, did not play the singles. She played the teams. But when you play recreationally, if you play ping pong with friends, you might see those little bumps that look like Legos. Now, those are called pips, or in Europe, pimples. And the length of the pip, or pimple, will determine how much spin can be generated. Mima Ito uses short pips on her backhand, which means that she can play the ball fast and flat. When it's her backhand, we call it Mima punch. And when she plays fast and flat with her forehand, meaning no spin, we call that Mima smash. Now, most people spin the ball a lot in table tennis at the professional level to help their chances of making an aggressive shot from even low. And Mima Ito, yes, was shut down by Sun Ying Sha earlier today, but will be fighting for the bronze here.
Well, of course, she has already made history here in Tokyo when she teamed up with Jun Mizutani to give Japan its first ever gold medal in this sport, and that's an incredible achievement. So that is Yu Mengyu, the 31-year-old world number 47 from Singapore. She took bronze in the Asian Games in Indonesia in 2018. She reached the quarterfinals in women's singles in Rio in 2016. She was injured in her semi-final match, but she lost to the world number one earlier, so it'll be interesting to see how she goes this evening. Of course, there's been so much talk about the 20-year-old, the world number three this week, and rightly so. She is an absolute star. Bronze medalist, of course, from Rio, and she's already won a gold at these games in Tokyo.
So Mima Ito, adoringly known as Mima-chan in Japan, for those of you not traveling to Japan so often, Chan is often added to the back part of a shortened girl's name, and boys, for example, Tomokazu might be Tomo-kun, and Mima Ito might be Mima-chan. So this battle will be a best of seven battle. Right here, the coin toss. Service, Mima Ito wins the coin toss, and the right side of the table is chosen by Yu Mengyu. So Yu Mengyu, best world ranking number 9, means she's been in the top 10. It's been a long time since then, but she is having the tournament of her life. In the corner for Mima Ito, Coach Matsuzaki, that's short for, it's Taisuke Matsuzaki. Much like a father figure to Mima Ito, because when you become a full-time professional by 12 years old, you spend a lot of time on the road. I don't know what you were doing at 12 years old, but flying in planes around the world to compete with the best in the sport, that's what Mima Ito was doing. Yu Mengyu's corner, Hao Anlin, a young father, a very friendly, lovely guy who's been alongside Yu Mengyu for this entire shocking tournament. Again, the 26th seed making it to the final four. Think about how unlikely that is. Think about how many other people. The 25th seed isn't here. The 19th seed isn't here. What about the third seed and the fourth seed? Well, the third seed is on screen, but the fourth seed, Zheng Yijing, had been knocked out by this player right here, Yu Mengyu. Same with Kasumi Ishikawa. She's just been so quick, Yu Mengyu. They're going to check out each other's equipment to make sure they're very familiar with what's on each side of the racket and then hand it back. So Yu Mengyu has a Chinese setup. With the black rubber on the forehand, the sponge, the layer between the black and the blade, is very hard and very heavy. What that means is it's going to play the ball short very well inside the table. It's going to be slow. But if you get a fast swing, it's really going to grip the ball well, and the power will be there. It's a tacky Chinese rubber. You can hear that clicking sound. Here's a list of some of the people that have fallen at the hands of Yu Mengyu. Xiao Jenny of Portugal, Zheng Yijing, the fourth seed from the Chinese Taipei team. USA's Liu Juan, just too many on that list when you're playing the bronze medal match. You know, she had considered retiring. She's been dealing with back injuries and other injuries for a long time now, more than 5 years, and here she is having the tournament of her life. But Mima Chan on this side, standing 152 centimeters tall, that's about 5 feet, took down Fu Yu of Portugal, Sutasini Sowetabut of Thailand, Jun Ji Hee of Korea. But Sun Ying Sha will be playing for the gold medal match. Look how compact this backhand stroke is. In the women's game, they tend to play closer to the table and more for speed, so reaction time as fast as can be, and a little bit less spin than usual. Our umpire for the match, Svetozar Hristov from Bulgaria. He ran the Bulgaria Open in the past, is a very generous, hardworking man, also an international blue badge umpire, which means he is the cream of the crop. Now, there was mention of the injury earlier today for Yu Mengyu. When she played her match against Chun Meng, world number one, it seemed that she was on the ground for some time, and from what I hear, she wasn't able to move for much of the rest of the match. Now, at the same time, this could be the biggest match of her career. If she can take a bronze medal here as the 26th seed, it would be mind-blowing. Singapore's news would be overflowing with table tennis joy and pride. And when you're home to Feng Tianwei, the world champion of 2010 who took down Liu Shiwen and Ding Ning, the Queen of Hearts, it's impressive. She's the second on her team in Singapore, yet she's here fighting against the rest of the world and Japan's ace in the hole, superstar Mima Ito. There was a look at the table from the side. You could see the T. So it will be a quick game. Now, I talked about the short pips. Mima Ito has more shots in her repertoire, more service style and swag than anybody in the game, man or woman. Ito to serve. Bravo. So here we go, best of seven, love all. The Mima smash was deflected. Self-defense out here. Yu Mengyu anticipates well, keeps the racket high right out of the gates. You saw that flat-hitting, crushing forehand, but well-prepared. Yu Mengyu takes the first point on the receive. And a lower, safer, more secure shot with heavy topspin here. Now, Mima Ito's only going to be able to hit those flat shots when the ball sits up a little bit high. Spin is what makes table tennis magical, and it's necessary to secure the shot early in the rally, typically. Yu Mengyu with the serves. Now again, the short pips generate less spin than the forehand side of the racket that Mima uses. So the ball will naturally come back into the net or lower. It's going to be on Yu Mengyu to open her racket and lift a little bit when she counterattacks. A nice change of placement on the serve, deep to the middle of the table. In the women's game, I mentioned it's so fast, they're going to be aiming not for the corners so often, but more so for the elbow, the middle point of the crossover section. Fancy serve to come. Good spin, deep to the backhand corner. Now, I mentioned the injury. I'm thinking if I'm Yu Mengyu or Yu Mengyu's coach, I do everything I can. I hit the cryo chamber, I rest, I relax, I get massaged. I come out here and I give one match like it's the last match of my life. Oyster shell reveal, the serve. Mima Ito's delivery, she's constantly changing up the way she presents her serve to keep it unpredictable. And a tomahawk chop block attempted. So far, Yu Mengyu is keeping this tight.
What do you think her game plan is coming into this match then? As we've said, there is a gulf in world rankings between the pair. What will the coach have said to her? How is she approaching this?
Yeah, that's an excellent question. First of all, with the injury, every single point play, finish the points quickly, and don't forget when it's flat, you have to open the racket. Lead service. Sun Yingsha demonstrated that so well. And also so far, in terms of specifics, Yu Mengyu has to surprise Mima Ito. She's got to keep her guessing, getting to the ball a little bit late. If the serve is long, it has to be very specific in the placement to surprise Mima-chan. Otherwise, it's going to be half long, meaning Mima shouldn't be able to tell if the ball is going to come off the table or not. Yeah, tactically, being an injured player, especially when you're playing a team event, and even though this is the singles, it's still, she's carrying the weight of the entire country, the pride of her coach, the association, and everyone who's ever helped her right now. And she's fired up. I mean, these balls, normally Mima Ito's backhand punch, the Mima punch, will finish that point quickly. But she's trailing, second serve. Excellent counterattack, spin for spin. Mima Ito playing a bit more conservatively here. Instead of hitting the flat shot, she arcs it up. Bit of side spin on that bending backhand, but a good angle here, testing the wingspan right now, the mobility factor for Yu Mengyu. The banana split over the table. That's when Mima Ito comes around the outside of the ball, sometimes adds a bit of underspin to it. The banana flick is normally a top and side spin shot, but it's top with it. Mima did straight side there to cause some trouble, but Yu Mengyu well prepared. Extends her lead back to 6-5. There it is, Mima punch. First one spinny, second one flat and fast. So with the second towel break of the game, it's dead even here. You could see the ball kick up and catch the edge of the racket. That's a very common reaction, believe it or not. I know it looked quite dramatic, but it's what happens when the ball hits the edge of the racket and you didn't expect it to. Now you'll see a lot of different psychological tricks from Mima-chan throughout. At times she'll be smiling, breathing out the corners of her mouth to keep positive. Quality push, the fire is very much alive in Yu Mengyu right now.
Yeah, absolutely, and you were saying before this that she's considered retirement, and this could be her last Olympics, as we were saying earlier, and if it is the last game of her life, then she's gonna give it her all.
Absolutely. Well, this is really tough right now. I don't know how much of it is nerves or simply that she's playing a different player. Again, sometimes the injured player, while at a major disadvantage, they change their game. And that makes it very difficult for a player who might have been prepared for a faster pace of play. I mean, Yu Mengyu is known for her speed. Right now, it's control and precision in placement. Protecting things on the serve. Now, the serve in table tennis, if you're new to the competitive sport, it might look crazy to you. You're wondering, what all is going on? They're just hitting a light ball. But the entire body is working to generate spin while also being deceptive, making the serve very subtle at the point of contact and then sometimes doing an after motion to confuse the receiver. And the placement right now, short points. When you're an injured player, you play short points. And it is 4 game points for Yu Mengyu, a player that I thought would have no chance in this match based on injury and head-to-head. An 11-6 domination right now from Yu Mengyu. What a shock start. Again, it's a best of 7 match. first player to win four games will win the bronze medal, and fourth place is probably the toughest place to swallow, the toughest result to go home with. Game two in this best of seven, Yu Mengyu versus Mima Ito, right after this.
So players back at the table for the second game here. And do you think that the semi-final that Mima Ito lost is having any kind of impact on her this evening? Because, like you said, she should be running away with this, but she's lost the first game.
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. I think that normally, I mean, she's 7-1 head-to-head against Yu Mengyu. The last time Yu Mengyu beat her was in 2015, and that's 6 years ago. Mima Ito was 14 years old. So the 20-year-old, the favorite to win, shuffling the feet, keeping the knees loose on the receive, down 0-1 in games. Again, the shorter the point, the better chance the underdog has. It's just the law of averages. The longer you keep the ball in play, the more likely the likely outcome will be. That might not have been perfectly worded, but hopefully the point is made. Oh, look at the side spin on that ball, on the move, the hooking forehand. This is the beauty of table tennis, the way the ball just hooks, dives, and dips. If you've never played with a professional racket before, find one. It changes the game forever. That's what got me hooked. Clearing the table. Fly? We got Sweat Squad. Do they handle flies as well? Let's see. She definitely wasn't. She could have been trying to dry off sweat, but that'd be a bit of an unusual way to do it. All right, you'll get to meet Sweat Squad later. They're cool. One serving one. Yu Mengyu is playing everything right. Service game of Mima Ito is the best in the world. The ball kicks up, it jumps in different ways. She's just so tough to receive. But Yu Mengyu, no trouble yet. And she keeps it low and baseline at the table. Now, Mima Ito's main weapon is the fact that she can kill the ball, that she can play it fast and flat. But if you keep it low and deep on the table, it's just too high risk of a shot. And right now, Yu Mengyu doing an excellent job of keeping it low and deep on the table when the rally starts. Mima smash goes long, a good long serve, very specific, nothing left in between. If Yu Mengyu does anything without a sense of clarity or a plan from the beginning of the point, she's gonna be eating her serve as Mima Ito crushes the next ball. Yet here she is leading 3-2 and 1-0. Nice change of depth on the table. A little bit more shallow inside. You could see Yu Mengyu leaning way forward. It's got to be a fly. She's very gentle. Just moving it, relocating it. There's a better view somewhere off the table, fly. Great education for your children. Local stores. On top of the bounce again, the wristy, agile Yu Mengyu backhand. Quite unpredictable. Singapore delegation in the crowd there. Tomahawk serve, much like you would throw a tomahawk axe, straight side spin, but Yu Mengyu reads it like a book. Oh, there it is. Mima smash abbreviated, a short stroke with little backswing. It's been few and far between that she's been able to sneak one past Yu Mengyu.
The expression's so hard to read. What do you think she's thinking?
I wish I were in the final for the gold medal right now. Unfortunately for her, I don't think it's helping her chances. She's a professional. She's one of the best in the world, world ranked number three. She can't be thinking that right now, but it looks a little bit like she might. I really do think she set her standards incredibly high because Mima Ito, really, table tennis, China dominates. It's China versus the world, and even Chinese fans want some challenge. They just do. They want to have to know that their cheers mean something for their players, that they're needed. And Mima Ito is the only person that China has prepared for. They don't need to prepare for anyone else. Just to follow up with that anecdote, at the private training camps for the Olympic Games in China, they have a wall for the men with three tiers of men that they consider a threat. The first tier is Lin Winru, the silent assassin, Tomokazu Harimoto, Dima, Timo, Liam Pitchford, maybe one other. Second string, not quite as threatening. On the women's side, they only have one player. It's just a giant picture of Mima Ito. So in front here, I think if she gets one game on the scoreboard, she'll be a little bit more present in this match. You can see the pips on the backhand side, the red.
Of course, she has been in this position before. We saw her in that gold medal match in the mixed doubles, coming from two games behind to win the medal.
Oh yeah, no, she's a comeback queen. I mean, she's been down a lot. I saw her against one of the world's top choppers, Han Ying, come back from 0-3, and she was just 14 years old at the time. And they were the fastest next four games you've ever seen, especially against a chopper. She's definitely capable and expected to win this match, but Yu Mengyu seems very well prepared here and is definitely coming to make this a match. That half-long serve, you see the indecision on the receive? So those of you newer to table tennis, a short serve will bounce on the receiver's side twice. A long serve will not, even if it comes off the side. A half-long serve is one where you can't tell if it will or not. And what happens is the receiver makes a decision late. And by making that decision late, Sweat Squad, Sweat Squad, out. So most serves are going to be half long, but for the injured player, you'll see long serves, surprising variation in her delivery. And a long serve to start it off to get right into the rally. Little apology there for the top of the net. Is that Deng Jian? Wow. I miss my friends. After a year and a half, this is the most exciting table tennis event you could possibly come back with. 7 points apiece. And a quiet chole there from Mima Chan as the serve drifts a little long, but deception on the spin. Now when she's wiping her racket, you'll also see players breathing on the racket, blowing on the hand to keep them dry so sweat doesn't mess up their grip or loosen the grip. But they'll clean off the racket. Sorry, just clearing the fly. They'll clean the rubber to make sure that they can spin the ball. Sweat Squad, man, Sweat Squad back again. Sweep it to racket, let's begin. Those aren't the lyrics. Here we go, 8-7. And the brushing backhand carries long. Yu Mengyu finds the elbow of Mima Chan, gets her to move to the middle. It was a smaller player. Normally the middle doesn't need to be covered with that backhand, but she's hesitant right now because Yu Mengyu's quick and she's playing to finish the point. Dangerous play, and the serve's on Yu Mengyu's side. There it is, the step around, less fear now. Looking a little bit more free. She started to anticipate there because so many serves have come long to the backhand. This is Yu Mengyu's tactic to try and get into the point. If she can do a fast long serve deep to the forehand from time to time, that'll keep Mima Ito honest, not able to move quickly or earlier on the receive. Banana split, but it's carried up and out, overlifted. Again, it looks like under and side, but that one appeared to be more straight side spin based on where the ball was lifted. So now 2 game points for Mima Chan. Chance to even out the playing field. Stop. And there it is, served to the forehand for the outright point, and Mima-chan ties it up one game apiece. Has she found her mojo? Has the Ito mojo come back? We shall see. A solid serve and a game three to follow. Stay right here. Game three, Mima Ito versus Yu Meng Yu, Japan versus Singapore, right after this.
Players making their way back into position now for game three, and it is a game apiece, finally poised here in the women's singles bronze medal match. And what do you think Mima Ito's coach was saying to her there?
What do I think her coach was saying to her? I think, first of all, breathe. Just breathe slowly and deeply. You'll probably see some breathing exercises out here from her. Relax. Take your shots. Don't be afraid to step around from time to time, but mix it up on the service placement. And already she's here at the center of the table for the serve. There it is, a Mima punch followed by a Mima smash. Corner to corner, coast to coast. Japan is the host that Mima likes the most. Would you like any toast? I did just offer my co-commentator some dorayaki, to be fair. Red bean paste, anko daisuki. That means I love red bean paste. True story. 1 point apiece, one game apiece, and there it is, cleaning the top sheet of the rubber for full spin and traction. And there's a little smile, that's good. That's the Mima that we've seen, that we know, that took the gold medal in mixed doubles for the first time in the history of that event. Yu Meng Yu, though, the fighting spirit's still very much here. Ah, that was He Keyi in the corner for Singapore. He's coached all around the world. Heavy topspin deep on the table. Now, if anyone saw the Sun Ying Sha Mima Ito match, Sun Ying Sha was so incredibly prepared. You can see the backspin here. That's why she has to lift up when she hits it to keep it out of the net. And drives it deep on the table. Cho to the lay. Some good footwork here. Now, while she is not the tallest player in the world, Mima Ito at 152 centimeters, nearly 5 feet tall, glides around so quickly. She's so light on her feet. And she's very athletic. I actually played goalkeeper when we were playing soccer or football to much of the world, and one shot, upper V, scored on me. Really, I have it on video. I mean, she's just an athlete, and she's so creative. Tomahawk serve with top inside spin, so the ball accelerates away from the net, speeding past Yu Meng Yu. Coach Mott satisfied with that. Very subtle. You could see the hard turn it takes with a little bit of topspin to go with the side spin. It helps the ball kick and take a sharper turn, really jump off that second bounce. Neither player going for the towel at the first towel break. Some confidence. So the trick with Mima Ito's game is when she plays these flatter shots that she's used to, if she's way behind the table, it's just a much lower percentage chance. That flat trajectory, she has the spin if she needs it, but as soon as she starts playing that game, she's playing a game that's familiar for Yu Meng Yu, and it'll be countered back, not as dangerous. And a good deep serve. Hao An Lin in the corner, you can hear shouting. This would be massive for Singapore. Again, it's only game three in a best of seven, so one player has to win four games. A long way to go, but it is quite exciting right now. Slow and spinny with the short pips. It's very versatile. Mima Ito can do almost anything with those short pips. And when she does spin the ball, the trick is how much spin is on it. Most players are using regular rubber on both sides, like Yu Mengyu's forehand and backhand. Spinny. Flat shot right into the middle and catches Mima Ito with the racket up like an ice cream cone. Elbow pinned. Underspin played back with underspin. And a very confident ball. If I hadn't heard about the injury, I wouldn't have even known the way Yu Mengyu's playing right now. Yes, the points are quicker, but she seems to be doing fine.
What does Mima Ito need to do now, then, to stop this momentum that she's got?
There was a good banana receive. What does she need to do? It's a good question. I think, one, testing the short forehand on the serve. At this level, most players have combinations. Much like in other sports, you do one thing and you know what's most likely to work off the back of it. So Mima Ito can serve short to the forehand and then play deep to the middle or backhand side of the table. Really test the in and out game. Force the injured player to use their feet. And a beautiful chop block from Mima Ito. That side and underspin, but Yu Mengyu not bothered right now. She's got this laser-like focus. That shot right there, so difficult to play against, and she hits the middle with the backhand. Yu Mengyu is a woman on a mission right now. 31 years old, had considered retiring before. I have her as world number 50 here. I know there are some differences in terms of rankings at the point of qualification, but Mima Ito is going to have to come up with some combinations, maybe look to step around and play the forehand deep cross court. Ooh, this is quite a reach. It's just nerve-wracking watching. You know, both players, of course, this is the biggest match of their lives. Thus far, Mima Ito is the heavy favorite to win this match. And if Yu Mengyu does it, I mean, they could make a feature film out of this story. I've got some personal stories having worked out with Yu Mengyu through injury, actually. I'll tell you about that in a bit. A good spin here with the backhand. Again, the short pips, tough to read how much topspin is on it because you know it's less than inverted rubber, but more than the Mima punch. If looks could kill, huh? Ooh, a little bit more shallow. Now this is something else I'm thinking, that if she can change up the depth, break the rhythm. After all, Yu Mengyu is a speed player. So that ball just slightly more inside the baseline, and again, the spin with the short pips. There it is, short forehand and deep to the middle, the combination. Happy to see it working out for Mima, John. That said, Yu Mengyu has been incredible, and I would love to see this go to the seventh, regardless of who wins this sweat squad. Bum, 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 bum. Three game points to Mima, John. And it's the edge of the racket, a tight serve, well placed from Mima-chan. 11-7, she takes the game. You've got to love the way she stares down the ball as it sits in the palm of her hand, taking up most of that hand. It's almost as if she told the ball, we've got a deal, you know what I want you to do, right? Well, the ball seemed to do it. Game three to Mima Ito. It's a 2-1 lead, and we'll be back for game four of the women's bronze medal match with Yu Mengyu and Mima Ito right after this.
そう、そう、そう、私服だからっていうの。ただ、自分は動いてる。その時に自分もゆっくりやらないと。
Players making their way back to the table now for game four of this women's bronze medal match. And it is Mima Ito who has a lead of 2-1. And this is finally poised, isn't it? We are on a knife edge here.
Yeah, you could say we're on a knife's edge, in theory. I've got this comfy seat, but I'm on the edge of it because, you know what, Yu Meng Yu is giving the real fight and has kept it quite close throughout. She's got the serves here. In a bit, I'll tell you a little bit about that notebook you saw in the corner with Coach Motz. The fascinating, mysterious notebook. And the strawberry comes out to play. Now, Mima Ito plays the strawberry more than almost anyone in the game, and the others who play it are her teammates that are not representing Japan in the Olympics, but more so as a backup and practice partners. The strawberry is the opposite side spin of the banana flick around the outside of the ball. And that's the banana split. Underspin and the banana Chiquita receive. Nobody does this except Mima Ito, maybe Hina Hayata from time to time. But Mima Ito, the creativity, top of the class. Mima smash for the win, sets it up. And there's Hina Hayata and the crowd clapping in the middle. See that ball, it's just such a dart. It's so straight, the trajectory. It's tough to counter without the spin. Tough to make in the first place, though. And good spin, Yu Meng Yu keeping it deep. Catches Mima Chan deep and a little bit behind the table. If she can keep Mima behind the table, she'll be very effective. And it's worked out for her well so far. After all, she won game one 11-6, Yu Meng Yu. Oh, countered right back, smoked on the forehand side. The cross-court winner just out of reach. Just when you thought those shorter arms wouldn't be able to cover the table. Watch this, way out on the backhand side, and so quick she floats and closes the racket to win the point. What a counter. There are probably things Mima Ito can't do. I just haven't seen them. Oh, the power on the step around. Quality shot from Yu Meng Yu, but a block back. There's Mima Ito on the left, Miu Hirano in the center. On the back right was Mika Baba, 7-time national champion for Japan, women's national team coach. But it's the personal coach in the corner, Coach Motz. He's the most chill guy you've ever met. Someone you want to talk to when you're under pressure. Just remind you that it's okay. Perfectly placed into the crossover, hits her in the pocket. So this is the score line that I was expecting a little bit more when I heard about the injury. Straight side spin there on the tomahawk, nearly anyway. Bit of top spin on it, but quite deep. And Yu Meng Yu hanging in there for every point. Like Zheng Jian in the corner. With the masks on, it's a little tougher. Haven't seen her in a while, but one of Singapore's strong players, future of Singapore. After all, Yu Meng Yu and Feng Tianwei, quite experienced. This is so impressive to me. So I was talking about the workout with Yu Meng Yu. She was injured, and I was invited to do a little physical training with her, and I could barely keep up, and she was doing light weights, said her coach. This was just weights. For her, it was like, yeah, just warming up. She looks thin, but she's solid. And trying to turn from the middle with the forehand as well. Yu Meng Yu having a little trouble. That's perfect placement for Mima Ito on the step around. Is this your first time commentating Mima at the Olympics?
I was there when she won that gold for Japan, beating China in the mixed doubles. I think that was my first time witnessing her.
That's right, I remember. I was watching from the other room. I thoroughly enjoyed that.
That was an incredible match.
Absolutely. Put that on your list of things to watch after tonight's session finishes, after the women's gold medal match following this. This one goes a bit wild. I'm curious to see if you notice any difference in the body language, anything changed between then and now for Mima.
Well, it was really apparent in that mixed doubles match. She started the first game looking so dejected, really obviously quite distressed at the scoreline. But as the match went on, she was much more expressive and you could tell she was having a really good time. And I think that's beginning to show now as well. Now she's put together a run of a few points. She looks so much more relaxed. She looks happy. You can see her smiling between points. And I just love how expressive she is.
Well, she definitely wears her heart on her sleeve. A lot of people have been curious to see her smiling during very tense moments against the top Chinese players. And I think it's often confused. I think for her, she's just continuing the tradition of the Japanese women to think positively. Over the years, if you've watched the Japanese women play, they almost always come back to their to the table shaking their head yes, nodding their head like I'm ready.
Positive mental attitude.
That's
right. Goes a long way.
Exactly. The power of belief. I mean, I'd sell you some placebo right now if it weren't for the glass between us. Just saying, it's a powerful thing. The power of belief. Keeping the hair out of the eyes. More hairpins and clips in table tennis. Again, unless you, Feng Tianwei used to rock the unicorn horn. Here we go, 8-6. And good placement again. Heavy topspin right at the baseline. And the timeout called on Mima Chan's side. I'll love to be in this conversation for just a moment, sitting with Coach Motz. There's a face, it's almost like a frog on a beach. Coach Motz just looks like he's on, oh, you can't see. Ah, you can imagine, looking at his relaxed eyes, his kind, relaxed eyes.
Tell us then about the significance of calling a timeout at this point in this game.
So in general, the coach's job, you only call a timeout if you think it will help your player win the match, if you think it's going to make the difference. It's sort of an emergency you need, this is the 1 minute. At any point, you can just pull the plug and say, let's talk. Sometimes a coach will say, hey, here's what I've got written down in the notebook. These are the things that work best for you. You've played this person 8 times before. And don't forget, she's a little bit weaker on the deep backhand, or she's slow to move in, or your backhand openings are very effective. Sometimes people literally, even if they're not table tennis people, they're just observant. I've seen this with parents of Olympians. They just take notes of what's working and what's not. And it's not an emotional thing. It's simply 85% of the time that you've played down the line, you've won the point. Good information, I will put that into play. It was a light conversation over there, considering the context of right now. He gave Mima Chan the chance to speak and then just reminded her what she's good at and what works well. And that's it. How many times has she done this tomahawk serve that dangles off the forehand side of the table? The smile's coming back. She's trying to bring back the energy that she's had throughout. The world knows she was hoping to be fighting for gold. But the Chinese delegation, China, sent 2 players with an outstanding record instead of the defending world champion, Liu Shiwen, who had a losing record to Mima Ito, which is, other than an injury, probably a big part of the reason she's not playing singles. A beautiful backhand off the bounce. Mima Chan now with 3 game points for a 3-1 lead. Oh, break off the top of the net. Quick apology there from Mima Chan. She's still finding herself. Doesn't look like the usual Mima Ito that I've seen throughout the last several years. That said, she goes up 3-1. The timeout has paid off. And we'll be back for game number 5. Yu Meng Yu and Mima Ito, stay right here.
We are ready to go now in game five with Mima Ito with a 3-1 advantage, and it is a must win for that athlete there, Yu Mengyu. If she is to stay in this bronze medal match, she needs to win this game. No pressure.
No, none at all. That said, when you are the underdog, there is less pressure on you because if you lose, that's as expected. She came out here and has already impressed and caused trouble for Mima Ito, no question about it. Now, much like Yu Mengyu wants to keep the points short right from the start, trying to win the points quickly so that she doesn't have to use her, say, legs as much or put herself at a disadvantage where she was injured, Mima's getting more adaptable and adjusting to the game. Oh, what a counter here, covers the middle. Yu Mengyu just bringing the elbow into the body and countering back with topspin, exploiting that open forehand. Don't get me wrong, no matter who wins, game seven, that's where the party's at. That's where I want to be. Oh, and a tomahawk chop block almost comes back after the banana split. She gets that racket head so low and just sideswipes the ball in the receive. And with the racket head up again, that tomahawk chop block, if it can come back on the table, is going to be an awkward ball. That said, Yu Mengyu's been very steady against the defensive play so far. Oh, just missing. For someone who wasn't expected to have the footwork or ability to move as well as usual out here, she covered a lot of ground in that point. So tied up now, 2 points apiece. Serves back with Mima-chan. Now, I could be wrong, but the last few times Mima has done this serve down the middle of the table, the variation in the spin has made the ball kick, so we saw a very cautious receive from Yu Mengyu. Otherwise, I'd just say it looked a little bit hesitant there, not the confidence we've seen. And trying for the forehand flick to finish the point early on over the table. At the first towel break, I will say that Yu Mengyu, oh, we got a timeout too for Yu Mengyu. All right. So people have asked before, a towel break usually is ballpark 10 seconds. If you take a timeout, does it add on? I think simply the timeout starts. No one's keeping track of the towel break anymore. Can't really hear what he's saying. Trying to listen. Not giving us too much to work with on body language either. So as the clock ticks down, I will say that Yu Mengyu, known for her speed, again, trying to finish the points quickly. Coming out here, she looked fresh. I mean, she got in the rally, she moved around. We even saw that point where she lobbed. If she spins it deep to the backhand, she's gonna be in a better position. In the women's game, backhand to backhand is where you see most of the points because the backhand is such a short stroke. It doesn't take much time to recover from. The forehand, on the other hand, is when you really have to get back quickly to a neutral position. So my thinking is, if Yu Mengyu can play deep and spinny to the backhand corner until she notices that Mima-chan is anticipating a little bit or creeping around that backhand corner, and then just from time to time to go out wide to the forehand. The long serves to the backhand were effective, but if you do anything too long, people adapt quickly at this level. So surprise factor, top of the priority list. She goes short to the forehand to keep Mima guessing. I think that's a good answer as well, because Mima-chan might be expecting deep to the backhand. But the quick feet gets her in, controlling over the table. Extending the lead to 3 points. Now, in case you were curious about the rule, a ball that hits the net and then goes in on the serve is a let service, and it can happen an infinite amount of times. Assuming you could live forever, which, well, no one has proven it's possible yet, but you never know. 6 serving 2, serves back with Mima Ito. Oh, just too tough. You can see she doesn't have it in the legs right now. Again, this is a very temporary thing throughout this tournament. Yu Meng Yu has been unstoppable, except for in the semifinals, of course, which is why she's fighting for the bronze. Ooh, double happiness. Mima was just pausing for a minute, like, is this real? Did that just happen? I like that look. You talked about her expressiveness earlier. She's given us some amazing poses over the years. She's just full of personality. She's quite the funny person. Ooh, clever idea. Quite deceptive. Comes in showing push with the backhand and then flip. Deep the opposite way, but just missing. And it's a 3-point game now. Again, it's now or never for Yu Meng Yu. Oh, very difficult. Well anticipated. Mima-chan gets out to the wide forehand and brings it right back. That over-the-table play is very tough to execute, and especially when you're injured. Legs really having to get you in position because you're pretty much in the air when you hit it. Yu Meng Yu makes the shot, but it comes right back deep. So out of the second towel break, 4-point lead for the third seed. I don't know about you, but I feel like the sweater is starting to unravel. And the serve receive comes long. It is 6 game and bronze medal match points for Mima-chan to take home her second medal at this Olympic Games in her first appearance in women's singles. But a long serve into the backhand side saves a match point. What are you thinking?
I'm thinking that that bronze medal is going to Japan, but never
Not
say
over
never.
Yet. That's right. Isn't that ironic that the word's twice in that saying? Ooh, deep to the backhand, this time a pendulum serve with some underspin on it. This would be absolutely crushing for Mima Ito in terms of mental challenge if Yu Meng Yu is able to come back. We've seen things like this before throughout this tournament. It gives the player, the underdog, some real confidence and motivation. Can feel the pressure building. 4 bronze medal points left for Mima Ito. Lead services, no limit, but you don't want to flirt with the net too much on your serve. And there it is, Mima-chan does it. She takes home the bronze medal in the 2020 Tokyo Women's Singles event to add to her mixed doubles gold medal. The 20-year-old at her first appearance has brought Japan their second medal. And while I know she would have liked to be fighting for the gold, she pulled through after a very tough start from an incredible performance out of Yu Meng Yu. A very respectable and incredible tournament for Yu Meng Yu. Hats off to the Singaporean who had the tournament of her life at 31 years old. And while she started strong, she's not number 2. She's number 3 here in the singles event. But peacefully so indeed. Yata, she has done it. She has taken the bronze medal. Well, this was a bit of a surprise here, and I'm really thankful that Yu Meng Yu brought such a fight from the start. But also, again, to her friends and family, I know that if she played the same way she had against Kasumi Ishikawa in Zheng Yijing, this could have been a 7-game encounter.
Well, she certainly made it interesting, didn't she? Taking that first game, as you can see there on the score graphic. But what a week Mima Ito is having. She's made history already heading into this match, and she's done it again, and she is really doing Japan proud.
So here's a look at the match stats, a 4-1 victory. The longest rally, only 11 strokes, 47 minutes, way outdid our predictions here. Points on serve, 27 for Mima Ito, but that's credit to Yu Meng Yu on the receive. Normally, she'll get about 4 to 5 points a game on service alone. And normally at this level, you're serving to set up the third ball attack. Mima Ito has a third ball attack that nobody wants to get in front of. It's just out of this world. That's why it's got a nickname. Mima smash on the forehand, Mima punch on the backhand. So you've seen the bronze medal match. It is Mima Ito of Japan who overcomes Singapore's star, Yu Meng Yu, the 26th seed, who pulled off some outstanding performances to be here. But you can see that Chun Meng and Sun Ying Sha will be battling in an epic match that could go either way for the gold medal. And here we have the highlights for Yu Meng Yu versus Mima Ito, the bronze medal match. 5-5 in the first, dead even. They were back and forth in this tug of war battle. The banana split with the Mima punch. Yu Meng Yu on top of everything here. It was almost like there was some 5-hour energy or something inside her that had started 4.5 hours ago, because the first half an hour of this match was very close. Yu Meng Yu in the lead on her second serve here in game three. The chop block didn't bother. She extended her lead, but then after going up 7-5, five in a row for Mima-chan. Oh, and a break off the net there, a bit of fortune. She apologized, but the damage was done. This was the one. If this lob comes down, it'd be quite interesting. You can only imagine a ball that bounces 7 feet in the air to somebody 5 feet tall. Huh? Nani? What happened? And now 4 match points. This was the last, the chance for her to put the bronze medal in the bag, and she did it. 4-1, collecting medals left and right. A gold in mixed doubles and a bronze in women's singles, Mima Ito. Doing Japan very proud out here. You're watching Tokyo 2020 Table Tennis.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs du simple femme.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the women's singles.
皆様、ただいまより女子シングルスの表彰式を行います。
Veuillez accueillir les médaillés.
Please welcome the medalists.
Medalistes をお迎えください。
Konnichiwa and irashaimase. Welcome back to Tokyo 2020. It's been the wonderful world of table tennis, and this is your chance to see the stars, the medalists from the women's singles event. And it's been quite an event so far. And there's so much to say about all these athletes. The top 3 women at the Olympic Games are walking out right now. Sun Ying Sha in front, followed by the gold medalist Chun Meng, and socially distancing Mima Ito of Japan. She has no reason to hang her head. She has made Japan so, so proud. At only 20 years old, she gave a strong fight to the strongest players in the game.
The medals will be presented by
Medal の贈呈は
Monsieur Sern Yang Eng, Vice President du CIO, Singapore.
And from Singapore,
Vice President, Singapore.
There he is, the Singapore, or Singaporean IOC Vice President, Mr. Ing Sir Myung.
Accompanied by
続きまして
Monsieur Zoran Primorats, président de la commission des athlètes de la Fédération internationale de tennis de table, Croatie, Olympien, une médaille d'argent.
The legendary table tennis player, the ITTF Athletes Commission Chair, Mr. Zoran Primorats, seven-time Olympic athlete, two-time men's World Cup winner. Also, one of the most handsome men to have ever played the game. I think even though he's retired, he's in better shape than most of us. So, a lot of respect here. The top women athletes in the world.
Bronze medalist, Japan.
Gold medalist, Nihon, Ito Mima.
And representing Nihon, Japan, it is Mima Ito, the bronze medalist. Omerito gozaimasu. An incredible tournament so far. Already a gold medal, the first ever gold medal with Jun Mizutani in the first Olympics to have the mixed doubles event over the Chinese opponents, which seems unthinkable but inspires hope for the rest of the world. And in singles, I think the best years are still to come. She says, thank you, I like it. Sort of smiling with the medal in the eyes there. You know she really wanted to be playing for the gold medal. But head to head, the two opponents that medaled higher than her were very strong and earned it, no question about it. Mima Ito will continue to innovate, create new serves and shots with new nicknames, and wow the world, and continue the good fight against the dominant athletes of China.
Gin medalist, Zhuka Jinlin Kyokaku.
Sun Ying Sha.
And now our silver medalist, Sun Ying Sha, 20 years old, the young superstar. So much fun to watch, and really gave an incredible fight. It takes two to tango. And with Chun Meng on the other side of the table, very few can keep up with the dance. Again, only 20 years old and did her job of making it all the way to the finals so that China would take home the two highest places. And at her first appearance, takes a silver medal. In terms of the greatest of all time, there's always a chance in the future that you are looking at the best to have ever played.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion, People's Republic of China.
金メダリスト、オリンピックチャンピオン、中華人民共和国。
Chun Meng.
And here she is, the Tokyo 2020 gold medalist, the champion of the women's singles event at her first appearance at the Olympic Games, Chun Meng. Big Dream herself is living the dream right now. She was simply unstoppable, and when things were scary, when she was on her back in the finals of the 2015 Asian Championships, she was down. She was out temporarily, but she only worked harder, came back stronger, more fit. And for this moment, is the best player in the women's game on earth. She has earned this gold medal and inspired future generations of players all around the world, men and women alike, boys and girls, to try and raise their level and up their game. The athleticism, the spin, the control. But now we'll have the national anthem
People's Republic of China.
For China.
皆様、中華人民共和国国歌の演奏です。
And there you have it, the most famous national anthem in table tennis, the Chinese national anthem.
Ladies and
you can be seated.
The Olympic medalists.
皆様, Olympic medalists.
For me, the highlight of the, and we're going to have a few moments where the masks are off for the photos, the smiles come out, and the charm can be seen. Chun Meng, again, one of the kindest. She's just so bubbly and friendly, really. As focused as she is over the years, whenever I've seen her at tournaments, she would always smile and say hi, even in tough moments. And the smile comes back out now. While they'd normally socially distance, I think Chun Meng said, hey, you wanna get together? Come close. They're all really good friends. Oh, I don't know if it's a social distance, we'll see. I like it. Oh, mask on. For me, the highlight so far of the medal ceremony was when Mima Ito told Sun Ying Sha to turn her medal around. She said, oh, you got it backwards. They're very close. And you can see the difference in height here. 152 centimeters, Mima Ito, and the gold medalist Chun Meng. Just so strong. Get to know their personalities, search them up on the internet. They are so much fun. And while they're full-time athletes, just like you and me, people with hobbies, passions, and desires, and one day, hopefully long, long from now, when they're no longer playing, it could be a bakery like Li Xiaoxia. It could be studying like Deng Yaping. But there are so many lives to live in one lifetime. Right now, I'm just thankful that we have an Olympics Tokyo 2020. Again, table tennis is magical. It is so much fun to watch and even more fun to play. Just try testing out some good equipment, learning to spin the ball. But to be able to watch the best athletes in the world here, if you had asked me 2 months ago, nothing was certain. But Tokyo 2020 has already been a magical experience. And with more table tennis to come, I hope that you've enjoyed the women's singles event as much as I have. And again, omerito gozaimasu, Mima Ito, and gongxi nimen, Sun Ying Sha, and Chun Meng, congratulations to our medalists. Chun Meng on top of the world.